Oil prices soaring above $135 a barrel at the start of the week. That's after the U.S. said it's exploring the idea of banning Russian oil imports along with its European allies. The move that will fan supply fears in an already volatile market. The global benchmark Brent crude jumping as much as 18% to $139 a barrel in early trade, following a 21% gain last week. The U.S. West Texas Intermediate is trading at around $128 a barrel. Both contracts hitting their highest since July of 2008. This is around the global financial crisis time. The spike also coming after U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken said the Biden administration is already discussing the potential ban with lawmakers. Russian oil making up 3% of all the crude shipments in the U.S. last year. Europe is far more dependent, with an estimated 30% of its oil supply coming from Russia. But it is growing more open to the ban, with no near end in sight to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Asian markets dropping at the open amid the spike in oil prices, with ongoing Russia-Ukraine war continuing to weigh on investor sentiment. Markets in Japan leading losses, with the Nikkei 225 down nearly 2.5%, South Korea's KOSPI index falling 1.7% in early trade, while Australia's ASX 200 is down 0.6%. Over in the Middle East, markets mostly rising on Sunday, with Saudi Arabian shares closing higher, tracking a rise in oil prices, and as the kingdom lifted all COVID-19 restrictions. Now, over on Wall Street, U.S. stock futures are in the red as oil prices jumped to their highest level since 2008 amid the ongoing war between Russia and Ukraine. So far, the tech-heavy Nasdaq is poised to lead declines when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, remember, on Friday, all the major indices slipped as developments between Russia and Ukraine eclipsed a positive U.S. jobs report. Data showed the U.S. economy added 678,000 jobs in February. That is way better than the 440,000 estimate. The U.S. unemployment rate also slipping to 3.8%, but the upbeat data weren't enough to lift investor sentiment as the conflict in Ukraine continued to escalate.
When the word nuclear is being used on headlines, I think that that is something that gets people's attention. None of us have ever experienced this type of geopolitical conflict before. We believe that this is a game changer in terms of sentiment and how it's going to weigh on people. And that is why we believe that the ability to remain flexible is going to be critical as we navigate through these next few weeks.
Looking ahead, investors will be monitoring the release of the U.S. February inflation print, which is due out on Tuesday. Now, the exodus of companies from Russia continues. American Express is suspending all of its operations in Russia and Belarus following what it called as Moscow's unjustified attack on Ukraine. Amex follows its U.S. counterparts Visa and MasterCard, which also announced the suspension of their Russian operations over the weekend. Russian lenders are now scrambling to find a workaround after the ban. It's reportedly looking at the possibility of issuing cards using the domestic payment system, MIR, and China's UnionPay. Accounting giants KPMG and PricewaterhouseCoopers also cutting ties with Russia. KPMG said its Russia and Belarus firms will leave the KPMG network, a move that will affect over 4,500 of its partners and staff. Now, as for PwC, its exit in Russia will affect 3,700 partners and staff in the country. Meanwhile, TikTok will also be suspending live streaming and uploading of videos in Russia as it reviews the country's fake news law that's aimed at silencing dissent and limiting information about its invasion of Ukraine. And after suspending production in Russia, Netflix is shutting down its operations in the country. No new customers will be able to sign up, and it's still unclear what will happen with existing accounts there. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky announces more Starlink internet terminals are set to arrive there as SpaceX CEO Elon Musk ramps up support for the besieged country. We have more in this report.
Добрый вечер.
Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said he spoke with SpaceX CEO Elon Musk on Saturday, confirming that next week Ukraine would receive more Starlink satellite internet terminals. In a tweet, Zelensky said he was grateful for Musk's support.
So if you have time after the war, you're very welcome. I invite you.
Yes, that sounds good. Well, I look forward to visiting.
Starlink operates a constellation of satellites that provide internet access across the planet. Starlink has been active in Ukraine for over a week after a plea from Kyiv for help in the wake of Russia's invasion of Ukraine, which Moscow calls a special military operation. Musk said on Thursday that Starlink is the only non-Russian communication system still working in some parts of the country. He warned on Twitter that Starlink's satellites could be targeted and advised users in Ukraine to turn on Starlink only when needed and place antennas as far away from people as possible. He said on Saturday that some non-Ukrainian governments requested Starlink to block Russian news sources. Musk fired back on Twitter, saying, "We will not do so unless at gunpoint."
Ukraine wants Russia and Belarus removed from the International Monetary Fund and World Bank. Ukraine's prime minister says he has signed a formal request to foreign governments to have the memberships of the two countries terminated as they have violated their obligations and directed their policies towards war. Meanwhile, the IMF said Ukraine's request for $1.4 billion in emergency financing will be up for the board approval this week. While devastating for Kyiv, the global lender also expressed concern over the war's severe economic consequences on the rest of the world. It said price shocks would be felt worldwide, so authorities should provide fiscal support for poor households. The IMF adds sweeping sanctions imposed on Russia by the West would also have a substantial impact on the global economy and financial markets. Moldova and other countries with close economic ties to Ukraine and Russia are seen to be at particular risk of scarcity and supply disruptions. Motorists here at home, not spared from skyrocketing crude prices due to Russia-Ukraine crisis, they are bracing for another round of oil price hike, the biggest so far this year. Diesel prices may jump by up to 5 pesos and 50 centavos per liter. Gasoline prices may go up by around 3 pesos and 80 centavos per liter, while kerosene prices may rise by around 4 pesos per liter. Public utility vehicle drivers are now calling on government to immediately approve their request for a fare hike.
Ang mahirap lang sa amin, mahal ang gasolina. Sunod, pangalawa, walang pasahero. Kailangan mo pumila para maka-pick up ka. Pangatlo, dapat sana i-ano natin, sana itaas natin sana yung ano, metro natin.
The looming oil price hike will be the 10th round for this year. Economic managers are set to meet to discuss ways to cushion its impact.
Binabantayan namin ng mabuti talaga yung kalakaran sa presyohan ng langis. Of course, yung nangyayari sa ano sa Ukraine and Russia, and then kung paano magiging epekto nito at ano yung pwedeng magawa ng ano ng pamahalaan para dito.
A local agriculture group is calling on government to remove the 12% value-added tax and excise tax on fuel. The Samahang Industriya ng Agrikultura, or SINAG, says doing so is the best move to control rising prices of goods, which is being triggered by soaring fuel prices. It adds the 500 million peso subsidy from the Agriculture Department to fisherfolk and farmers is not enough.
That will not help, no, because of the increase of fuel. Next week, additional ano na naman yan, additional 3 to 5 pesos. So, per liter. So, yung ibibigay nila, hindi makakatulong yun doon sa total increase ng fuel. Mm-hmm.